Welcome everybody to a quick little video showing you how to create a bill of material using Dynamics Nav. In this video I'm going to create a bill of material for a front wheel that can then be put onto a bicycle, and later in the process you can create a routing and a production order for this bill of material and create some items in production. Let's get started. So first thing we want to do is we want to open up our roll center in Dynamics Nav. We can use the Production BOM shortcut on our navigation pane if we have it, or up in the search function we can start typing for Production BOM and we can select the list from there. So as you can see, this brought us to our Production BOM list page. This shows me all of the Production BOMs that have already been created in the nav system. As I mentioned, we need a bill of material created for our front wheel, so the first thing we want to do is navigate to the ribbon and select New. So here we have a new production card page that's populated for us. What we want to do is we want to indicate a number for the production BOM. In most cases, we suggest that you can name it the same as the item card, which creates sort of a soft link between the two. However, this is completely up to you. If you have one bill of material that can be used for a variety of different items, you may choose to have a more generic product group or category code or different kind of indicator for the number. In my scenario, I'm going to name it 1100 FW, 1100 being the item card number, and FW just an indicator for myself that it's a front wheel. I'm also going to add a description for the bill of material. I need to select a unit of measure code. My status automatically defaults to new because I'm creating a new bill of material. At the end of this process, we will need to certify it, so then later when there's corrections that need to be made, we need to take it out of the certified status, move it to the under development status, and then we can make updates to it. I'll show you that later, but for now we need to keep it in the new status. We can leave version number because this is the first time we're building our bill of material. Now I'm going to draw your attention here to the lines section of the page. This is where I indicate which components are required for this bill of material so that at a later date I can consume these from inventory when I produce the product. The first thing I want to do is I want to select item because I want an item that is in my inventory item card list. I indicate which item number I would like. I've selected my rim. I need to indicate the quantity per. The quantity per indicates how many rims would I need to build one front wheel. So in this scenario, I would need one rim to build one front wheel. My unit of measure will pull from the item card. And I can also indicate some scrap if, for example, I wanted MRP or my planning to suggest a little bit more to account for any scrap. In this scenario, we don't have any, so I'm just going to leave that blank. And I'm going to continue adding items to my bill of material. Here we have spokes. I need 50 spokes in order to create one front wheel, so I'm going to indicate 50 under my quantity per. Again, I can leave my unit of measure as pieces. Because I know the item, I'm just typing it in. I can use the drop down here to look up from my items list, and I could select from there as well. So as an example, I didn't know the tire number, I've used my advance, I can see tire in my list, I highlight, and it selected it for me. Now added all of the lines to my production bill of material. So now that I've completed it, I just want to pop up to the header again, and in the status drop down I want to select certified, and now this production BOM is ready to be used in production. If you have any questions regarding billing a bill of material in Dynamics Nav, please feel free to contact www.sabrelimited.com or call 519-585-7524.